me some time to speak about Grandview Kids. I learned firsthand this summer how truly special this charity is by joining a walk-a-thon with my friend Karen. To see all those families and their children and the sincere appreciation and gratitude on their faces was truly humbling. The mission at Grandview is to give children and youth with special needs the opportunity to dream, learn, succeed, and belong. The center was designed in 1983, and there were about 400 children per year that were using the center. Now, due to our growing population and needs increasing, they're looking after 7,000 children and youth, but there's also a 3,000 youth and children waiting list, waiting for help. There's 21 of these centers in Ontario. Grandview is just one of them. It's located in Durham Region in Oshawa, and they are looking to build one in Ajax, hopefully in 2020. These centers offer rehabilitation and treatment for children and youth with special needs from birth to 19 years old. They have a wide variety of services, speech language pathology, audiology, physiotherapy, therapeutic recreation, family support, which is one of the key areas because the families as well as their children need the help of all the people around them. Day in and day out, the families that they're involved in Grandview witness firsthand how these special programs help their families and their children. It's really a community unto itself. The children and their families involved with Grandview are really part of the Grandview family. They get a sense of belonging and support that help the families dealing with some very difficult days. Thank goodness there's places like this to help both the children and their families. And in the words of Grandview, what we do together brings triumphs and joy into the lives of children and youth with special needs and their families. Our programs unleash limitless potential, inspire possibilities, and change lives. I know everybody can't see this, but I picked one child, this cute little girl. There were hundreds of stories, so between the Kleenex box and myself, I picked little Alejandra. So she was born with spina bifida and hydrocephalus. She had many surgeries. The first one was the day after she was born to close the hole in her spine and her exposed nerves. The second one was to drain the fluid from her brain, and after that, they had to do modifications to her bowels and bladder. She was referred to Grandview by SickKids when she was under a year old. She's now six in grade one. Grandview has helped her in so many ways. With occupational therapy and physiotherapy, speech therapy, they helped her with her motor skills, her crawling, and her walking. She's now using a walker independently, and she can get around easier in her wheelchair. And she says that her goal is to climb the stairs. So she's now in grade one, and Grandview is teaching her to use these skills, and they're trying to develop her her muscle strength and a lot of other things with these therapies so that they can teach her independence that will help her entire life. Alejandra's story is one of hundreds, stories of hope, inspiration, gratitude, and belonging. Providing assistance to Grandview Kids will go a long way in helping this organization continue to help the growing needs of children and youth in the Durham region who really need this help and deserve it the most. So thank you very much for listening, and hopefully Grandview was the winner for this evening.